What were the conquests of Alauddin Khalji? In Gujarat, he secured the services of the Anang slave Malik Kafur. And then this Malik Kafur, he became the general of this Alauddin's army. He also defeated the rulers of Warangal, Dwarasamudra and Mysore from South India. And then Alauddin Khalji, he became the first ruler of Delhi Sultanate to extend the kingdom south of the river Narmada. So up to the south part of the river Narmada, they extended their kingdom. How were the administrative reforms during this Khalji's period? So Alauddin Khalji, he was a good commander and an excellent administrator. The officials were forbidden from collecting taxes from the farmers. These sultans also put a check on the price of these commodities. And then they ensured that the soldiers could live within their income. They totally transformed the markets of the Delhi. They made arrangements so that large quantities of the grain can be stored and can be used when there is shortage. And after the death of Alauddin Khalji, the Malik Kafur placed Alauddin's minor son on the throne and tried to rule in his name. So in 1813-20, the last Khalji ruler, Khusro Khan was the last Khalji ruler. He was killed by Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq. And then this Tughlaq found the Tughlaq dynasty. Next came the Tughlaqs. They ruled from the AD 1320 to the AD 1399. So they ruled Delhi from this AD 1320 to 1399. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq was the founder of this Tughlaq dynasty. But later he was followed by his son Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Muhammad bin Tughlaq is the most famous ruler of the Tughlaq dynasty. Muhammad bin Tughlaq, he ruled from the AD 1325 to the AD 1351. He was a good, capable administrator as well as commander and a good scholar. His plans and intentions were good, but he carried them thoughtlessly in a hurry, which resulted in those plans' failure. So Muhammad bin Tughlaq is known as the confused genius in the Indian history. This is the image of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Next, Muhammad bin Tughlaq did shifting of his capital. In the AD 1327, he decided to shift the capital from Delhi to Devagiri, also known as Daulatabad. But this project failed due to two reasons. First thing is, he ordered the entire population of Delhi to shift to Daulatabad. This caused great difficulty to the people. Second reason, because they left the northwest frontiers of the empire exposed to the attacks of this Mongolian people. And then he realized his mistake and shifted the capital back to the Delhi. Then came taxation in Delhi. So this Muhammad bin ruler Tughlaq, he needed money to carry out his various plans. So in order to raise money, he raised the land tax in the fertile Ganga Yamuna down and introduced new ones. So then farmers faced lot of misery and then riots broke out. Then came token currency. In the AD 1330s, the Sultan issued token coinage. That means the coins were made up of brass and copper and were stamped with a value equal to that of silver, and then they were circulated. But this experiment ended in a disaster. So this was the token currency. How was the administration during the period of Muhammad bin Tughlaq? He was an excellent administrator. He conquered places such as Warangal, Malabar, Dwarasamudra and also Madurai. But he left out the Hoysalas and made his empire one of the largest ever ruled empire by any Muslim ruler in India. He also opened many hospitals and almshouses and he gave generously to the Muslim scholars. He didn't allow any religion and administration to mix up. Then how did the empire of Muhammad bin Tughlaq break up? In the AD 1329, the Mongolian people entered deep into the India. The breaking away of Malabar in the AD 1334, this was the beginning of this decline. Rajputs captured Ranthambore, Chittur back, and they established a powerful state in Rajasthan. Muhammad bin Tughlaq died in 1351 while trying to put down the revolt in the Sindh region. How was the administration under the Tughlaqs? So Iltutmish divided the empire into large and small pieces of land known as iktas. So all the officers, religious people, they were not paid a salary. Instead, they were given iktas. And these officials or iktidars, they had to pay the king a portion of the revenue they collected from the land. Next, let's see the role of the nobles. So nobles were mostly Turkish and Afghanistan people. They were very powerful. But the strong sultans, they tried always to break the power of the nobles. Then came the invasion of the Timur. So in the AD 1398, during the rule of Muhammad Tughlaq, Delhi Sultanate was attacked by Timur. So Timur was a Central Asian Turkish ruler. He embraced Islam and set up a kingdom in Samarkand. He also ransacked Meerut and Jammu. And then Tughlaq Empire never recovered. Next is the Saids and the Lodis. They ruled from AD 1414 to AD 1526. The Tughlaq's rule was followed by Saids and the Lodis. So they ruled for almost a century. Sikandar Lodi was better known rulers of the Lodi dynasty. And Ibrahim Lodi was the last sultan of the Delhi Sultanate. So the noble people, they revolted against this Lodi rule. And they invited Babur, the king of the Kabul, to help them overthrow the Ibrahim Lodi. But taking advantage of the situation, the Babur invaded India. And this Babur killed the Ibrahim Lodi in the Battle of Panipat in the AD 1526. And then Babur stayed and founded the Mughal rule in Delhi.